CNBC is all over the story with live team coverage from every angle. What's next for Madoff, his victims, and his family? We have our reporters standing by inside and outside the federal courthouse in Manhattan, and a couple of top lawyers right here in studio with us on Power Lunch.
Yeah, they are Jay Fahey, the former federal prosecutor, now with Fahey and Choi, and Tom Gorman, who's formerly with the SEC Enforcement Division, now chair of the SEC litigation practice at Porter Wright. Let me get your initial first blush reaction, guys, to the 150-year maximum sentence. Jay, a fair sentence?
It's a fair sentence, but I'm very surprised by it. The U.S. Probation Department made a recommendation to the judge of 50 years. I mean, Madoff's lawyers wanted 12 years. The government wanted 150 years. What judges typically follow what the U.S. Probation Department says and recommends. So I was surprised that it was this high.
Tom, does it square with you?
I think it is a surprising sentence, but I think the judge hit the nail on the head here. Usually the judge will follow the U.S. Probation Department's recommendation, which follows the sentencing guidelines, but the guidelines don't fit here. This is an extraordinary circumstance, as the judge said. It's an extraordinary crime with extraordinary impact, and the symbolism is very telling. And I think that's what the sentence is. 150 years, nobody can serve that. A forfeiture order, and don't forget about the forfeiture order from Friday, $171 billion. Obviously, he doesn't have that much money, but again, the symbolism here, the symbolism fits the crime.
All right, thank you, gentlemen. Let's get down to our Scott Cohn. Of course, he is at that federal courthouse in Lower Manhattan with more detail and more color. Scott, over to you.
If he were truly sorry, right, Tom, he could sit down and tell them how he did it. But we don't have that yet. To me, that would be the biggest signal. But to me, the rest of this sounds very disingenuous. Do you agree with that assessment?
I do. That's one of the really, truly extraordinary things about what's been going on here is Bernie Madoff has fallen on his sword, tried to absolve everyone else of responsibility. But as the judge said, he's not really cooperating. If he was really contrite, he could tell you what he did. He could tell you how he did it. He could tell you who else was involved. He hasn't done any of that, and that raises a significant question as to whether or not he's really sorry for what he's done.
So, bearing that in mind then, Jay, how does Ira Lee Sorkin justify asking for the leniency of 12 years? I mean, he did say, let's point out that $1.2 billion of the money has been recovered at this point as they've worked with the U.S. Attorney's Office, but when you have not had the cooperation, and this is something the judge pointed out, there has been a decided lack of cooperation from Bernie Madoff. How would you justify asking for 12 years here?
You know, Tom, I was struck by something that Harvey Pitt said on our air last hour. He wished that it had been a lesser sentence because now he thinks it will be harder to get any kind of cooperation from anyone in the family, even though there hasn't been any to date. How do you feel about that, and how do they go about trying to unravel the rest of this case now that he's gotten the maximum sentence?
Well, I don't think that that's going to affect the level of cooperation here, because if you look at what's going on to date, Bernie Madoff himself has given very little cooperation. His wife has given little cooperation. His family's given little cooperation from what everybody can see. What's happened is very clear. Bernie Madoff tried to fall on his sword. The family went the other way. Mm-hmm. They weren't at the hearing today, which is not typical in most of these cases. Usually the family might be there. Not this time.
But Tom, Harvey Pitt's point was actually, I thought, a really good one. He says, if you gave him only 20 years, then you throw out this carrot of the possibility that if he cooperated, he could get out. And we know how family dynamics are. Right now he's trying to protect the wife and kids, but you don't know if 5 years from now those sons do something that upsets him and he turns on them, if indeed they're involved. Wink, wink. You see what I'm saying? I thought Harvey Pitt had a great point there.
I think it's an interesting point to think about, but I think it's more theoretical than real in this particular case. The storyline for Madoff has been from the beginning, I'm the only guy that did this. He doesn't want to see his wife charged. He doesn't want to see the family charged. I don't think you're going to see him turn on them. If you said 10 years, Bernie, and you can get out if you turn on the family, I don't think that's what's going to happen here.
I think it would have been good if the judge had done that for this reason. That would be another pressure on him. Right now, there's no pressure on him. He's facing 150 years. If he had gotten a sentence of over 30 years, that's basically a life sentence for him. I think it would have been a smart thing to do. And then the pressure again is on him, that knowing that he has the key to unlock the door of his cell if he wants to cooperate.
Very quickly, Tom, isn't it amazing, at least by public accounts, that no one else in Bernie Madoff's office has come forward asking to turn in some way or other to cooperate with authorities here.
I mean, or do we know that? Maybe maybe it has happened.
Maybe
we don't know it.
But we don't know anything else about this case at this point, Tom.
No, that's right. I think that is fairly extraordinary. There doesn't appear, at least on the public record and in any of the cases that have been brought, nobody seems to be coming forward and saying they saw something, they heard something, they knew something, and frankly, that's just not believable. Somebody had to see something, do something, think about something. This is a very extraordinary circumstance. I can only think that everybody's just hunkered down right now, and they're very concerned about getting caught up in this huge, unbelievable fraud.
All right.
What will be important going forward, say legal experts, is to